first of the five tensile strands is doctrine, which is a set of beliefs held and taught by a church. There are also several other characteristic tensions involving doctrine. One concerns the status of God. Some believe in monotheism, which is worshiping one God. The other believe in polytheism, which you can see in Sampurna Ramana, which is worshiping more than one God. Another tension concerns the disparity between one's religious duty, as characterized by Dharma, and a release from an inherently flawed world, characterized by moksha. A third tension exists between the individual and destiny, as shaped by karma, and the individual's deep bonds to family, societies, and other divinities.
Many Hindus would place this strand of Hinduism above doctrine. While it is true that various elements of Buddhist rituals survive modern practices and thereby serve a undefying function, much more influential if it's performed by the priest, a temple. It echoes conversations of hospitality that might be performed for an honored guest, especially the giving and sharing of food, reflecting the reincarnation that human beings make offerings to. Okay, so the divine personality installed as a home or temple image, reverse prasada, tasting and offering the remains to worshippers, consuming their leftovers. A worshippers set their status as being infusion to and dependent upon the divine.
The four-class or caste system is the ideal version laid out in sacred texts. This, however, is not present in modern India. What is currently present is that there are hundreds, if not thousands, of divisions of classes, and these are usually based on family heritage of name or money, and so have nothing to do with the actual original division of Purusha, the cosmic soul. The idea behind the four-class system is that the four parts of the body achieve different purposes, and they achieve them in different ways. So the four-class system is intended for each part of society to achieve its purpose in the best and easiest way possible. When viewed in the unadulterated doctrinal sense, the caste system becomes a practical and actually very effective way to ensure that all members of the Hindu society and Hindu religion achieve moksha or enlightenment.
One of the aspects that help draw in Hindus into a single community is narrative and story. Most of these stories typically deal with either divine play and or interactions between gods and humans directly. These stories often depict different levels of basic human life between love, struggle, good versus evil, and then what someone's duty is. Specifically, an example of a story with duty is the Bhagavad Gita, where Arjuna is going through the struggle of finding out what balance in his life needs to be between duty and his divine right. Stories have been known to also have been told from different aspects and different characters in the same plot. For example, in this story specifically, it has been retold by female performers in India from the perspective of Sita and explaining her struggle of being under Rama's hands.
The fifth tensile strand of Hinduism is not necessarily as important for the devout Hindu, as most of Hinduism is centered on ritualistic practice. This practice, however, is instructed through doctrine, and this doctrine will instruct the Hindu practitioner in generally everything that they're going to do on a day-to-day basis in their life. So through constant exercise of this practice, the individual gradually gains more of this devotion. But what appears to be devotion could simply be a very strict adherence to a practice or schedule, much in the same way that our strict adherence to watching Netflix after class isn't necessarily an example of devotion. So it has no intense dedication, meaning there's no conscious intent, and it's just a habit, which kind of gets rid of the importance of devotion. So therefore, what appears to be devotion in an individual could just be an adherence to a habit. And so you can't really tell which individuals in Hinduism have true devotion and which don't. And for this reason, practice is a much better indicator of this kind of, well, dedication to the divine. And for these reasons, devotion is perhaps the least important of the five tensile strands.
महाराज दशरथ के सन्मुख अयोध्या के राज कलाकारों ने मदन दाह नृत्य आरंभ किया.
Here is the wedding between Rama and Sita. As you can see, they are performing a very energetic and elaborate dance. This would be something you would commonly see at a Hindu wedding.
महादेव की समाधि भंग करने के लिए कामदेव ने ऋतुराज वसंत का आह्वान किया.
To relate back to what I previously spoke about, narrative, a marriage ceremony is essentially a story. By following a very strict order of things, these events fall into place just as they would in a story. This strict structure even applies to parties associated with the bride and groom, where they have specific lines to say in certain orders.
कामदेव की पत्नी रति भी अपने स्वामी का साथ देने आ गई.
Now, how does this relate to the other tensile strands?
Well, this is a religious practice because it is not an expression of joy, as we see in a Western wedding, but rather a ritual to awaken Shiva from his meditation. The purpose of waking him is so that he may break old bonds and make way for new ones.
As for the society aspect, much of this wedding relates close to Christian weddings and other religious weddings, in the sense that this is a social event consisting of family and loved ones, much like you see at any other weddings that you've gone to.
How does this dance relate to doctrine?
There would be no practice without doctrine. The doctrine of Hinduism describes the rituals that would make a proper wedding. And so without doctrine, there would be no organized rituals.
Think a wedding or dance demonstrates devotion?
While it can demonstrate devotion, it clearly isn't as big a factor as the practice of the dance. As we can see, Rama's devotion doesn't matter as much as him performing the proper steps. Shiva doesn't take pleasure knowing Rama is dedicated to the dance, but from seeing him perform it. And so though devotion is present, it isn't as big of a factor as a Western wedding.
Hinduism does not have a single scripture at the source of its various teachings, but rather encouraging relative freedom of thought through defined codes of contact and morality.
The life of Hindu is filled with daily practices. Some of these include yoga, namaste, greeting, puja, and many more.
The society of Hinduism is a highly organized structure with ties to the idea of the creation of the cosmos.
Stories are such a huge part throughout any society, especially Hindu society, and their history, ranging from the Bhagavad Gita and the Sampurna Ramayana.
Devotion isn't such a large part of Hinduism as it is to Christianity. The religion is primarily realized through practice, and identifying with doctrine, practice, societies, and stories are what make up devotion for the Hindu.